So starting with the head circling the neck, staying a little bit crouched. And reverse. And you can let your eyes take the movement a little bit more, make it a little bit bigger, let your eyes lead the movement. And finishing that one, and coming to the hips, circling the hips, staying in the legs, and again two minutes, we'll do a minute one direction and then we'll reverse. And here's one to keep the gaze straight ahead, back straight, head up. Which I realise now means I cannot see the clock. So you'll see me looking down at times. And reverse, staying down in the legs, keeping the gaze forward, the head up. Hands on the waist, or hands on dantian, or hands by your sides. And the circles could be a little bit faster, probably a little bit smaller, or they could be bigger and a little bit slower. Okay, good. So let's just shake that out for a minute. And then we'll come to loosen up the ankles, knees. knees and the hips. So standing together, feet together, sinking down, weight into the left leg, taking a step with the right onto the tip of the toe, and then circles with the knee, the hip, ankle. Staying a little bit crouched in the left leg, and again, eyes forward, not on the clock. And reverse. Okay, and together, and then weight onto the right leg, little crouch, stepping onto the left toe, and again, circling the hip, kind of drawing a circle with the knee, rolling over the tip of the toe, opening up the ankle. Eyes forwards, head up, crown of the head up. Good, and reverse. Good, and stop. Kick out for a minute. And then again, feet together, crouch. One step forward. Bum back, back straight, just leaning a bit to stretch the back of the leg that's forward. Hamstrings at the back, just holding. A stretch there. Different ways to do this. Sometimes we do it still, like a static stretch. Sometimes like a sort of more dynamic stretch, sort of just a little bend, a little bounce of the leg. So one day you might feel like more like one or the other. And then coming back and stepping with the other foot, bending down, straight back, bum backwards. Stretching through the back of the other leg now. So the weight's on the bent leg, front leg straight. Hands resting just above the knees. You can press down a little bit onto the knee, or above the knee, just above the knee, just to straighten. Make sure that leg is really straight. Come back in and crouch again, take the step again. This time I'm going to just bend a little bit more, so the back becoming flat, sort of parallel to the ground perhaps. And you could reach down to the ankle, and again just really actively stretching that leg. Sometimes nice to sort of pull up the kneecap, helps to straighten the leg. Great. Stepping back in, other leg forward, bum back, folding at the pockets, folding at the hips, reaching down to the ankle, back flat. And just making sure that leg is straight, stretching it out, lifting the kneecap, using the quad muscles to lift the kneecap, stretching the hamstrings at the back of the thigh. Lovely, stepping back in. And then the last one, slightly different, bending, taking a step where you land with your heel, and then folding at the hips, reaching down, getting a good hold on the foot. So if this is too much, just go back to the middle one where you reach for the ankle with the foot flat on the floor. But otherwise, heel down, toe up. And again, straight leg. Lovely, stretching, standing back up, crouching again, step forward, land on the heel, bending down, folding at the hips, reaching for the toes. And if that's really not comfortable, not possible, go back to the middle step with your foot flat on the floor. Stretching that leg, straightening the leg to stretch the hamstrings. Bum goes backwards, weight on the bent leg. Lovely. Coming up, let's just kick out for a minute, check the back's happy. So we'll step into horse stance, two shoulder widths wide, sinking down, folding at the hips, and then keeping the knees out, and then turning the body to swing the arms. Eyes forward, steady gaze, back straight, head up. And we do this one for 2 minutes. As you feel looser, you could turn the head, turn the body. Keeping down in the legs, tendencies to lift up. So to stay down in the legs. Lovely, and then let's stop that. Coming into a shoulder width stance, so do shake out if you want to. Shoulder width stance, and again, sinking and moving the Good. So this is the position, the leg position, the stance we'll use for the standing meditation, the leg strengthening meditation. So as we come to stop this, we could go seamlessly into 8 or 10 minutes of standing. So from here, again, just regrouping, feeling your feet sinking into the hips, back straight, eyes forward, feeling the legs engaged, bringing the arms up, and letting the weight of the arms transfer through the body. And then you can close your eyes, listen behind, focusing on Dantian, and if you're familiar with the breathing technique, you can do that for a few breaths, maybe 8 breaths, where you're breathing in for 7, breathing out for the count of 7, breathing in, breathing out, and when you breathe in, breathing in up into the chest, expanding the chest a little bit. Breathing out, down into the Dantian, making the belly bigger. Breathing in, pulling in the belly a little bit, expanding the chest. Breathing out, down into the belly. Tummy big. Staying down in the legs, head up, mind calm. breathing in, expanding the chest a little bit, pulling the tummy in a little bit, breathing out, relaxing the chest, breathing down into the dantian. Weight evenly distributed left to right. Slight crouch. Hips back and down. Head up. Legs strong. Eyes soft. Coming into the last minute or so, so just sinking there a little bit more perhaps. Hips back and down, working the legs, staying calm. Slow, steady breathing. You've got this. You can do this. Okay, so slowly turning the hands to face the floor. Slowly lowering the arms down, staying in the legs. Feeling the fullness in the hands, the warmth. Coming up out of the legs. And closing. Done. Nice job.